baking smell of the graveyard. Once a year, we gather beneath our family tree to honor the great cycle of life and death. Come to me, every member of our clan, living, dead, and undecided, and let us celebrate what it is to be an Adam. Come to me, my beautiful wife of sheep, skin so fair, eyes so black, hair so long, and tell us what it is every Adam's hopes for.
Darkness and grief and unspeakable sorrow.
I love it when you talk like that. When you're an Adam's, you need to have a little room life. When you're in Browns, you need to feel a little chill. You have to see the world in shades of gray. You have to put some poison in your day.
That's the way.
When you're an Adam's, you need to have a sense of humor. When you're an Adam's, you need to have a taste for death. Who cares about the world outside and what it wants from you? When you're an Adam's, and now we summon our beloved ancestors. And how do we do this?
By dancing on their graves.
Yes, dance, my brother Fester. Time to wake the dead. Line dance.
Oh.
Diamonds, look.
Ugh, flowers. Who would send something so tasteless?
The most precious gift there is, more goodylicious than gold, is that blessing we call friendship, whether new or very old.
Goodylicious? Who talks like this?
The Beinekes, Wednesday's friend Lucas and his parents. They're coming for dinner tonight.
Lucas?
It's nothing, darling. Puppy love. Put these in water.
Mom, Dad, I shot dinner.
Oh, Wednesday, that's lovely. Wherever did you find it?
Petting zoo.
Thank you, dear. Come, Lurch, guest for dinner. Fresh meat.
Daddy, I have something very important to tell you. Can you keep a secret?
Of course.
Oh, Daddy, Lucas wants to marry me.
Oh, that's wonderful. Let's go tell your mother.
No, Daddy, please. She'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing.
But I've never kept anything from your mother.
Daddy, one tiny little secret? Please? Please?
Okay. I promise I won't tell your mother.
Oh, thank you, Daddy.
Oh, Wednesday, you're growing up so quickly, it'll be Thursday before I know it.
Run along now. What's wrong with Wednesday?
What if, and I have absolutely no reason to say this, what if she found someone who stole her heart?
Don't be silly. When that happens, I'll be the first to know. Wednesday tells me everything, just like you do. Gomez, you do tell me everything, don't you?
Of course.
Oh, please, no, not the game. Can't we all just act normal? Please?
Then dinner.
And after dinner, the game.
Oh yeah? What kind of game?
Did you ever play charades?
Yeah.
Well, it's nothing like that. Oh, come on now, let me show you the moat. Did you bring your bathing suit?
Did you get the flowers?
Oh, yes, and lovely poem. Wherever did you find it?
I wrote it.
No.
When I'm depressed or feeling blessed, a poem will get it off my chest. They come to me, they take their time, they just pop out and always rhyme.
Maybe you should see someone about that.
And here we have the family portrait hall. This is Cousin Helga from Baden-Baden.
Who's that lady on her shoulder?
Oh no, that's her other head.
She has two heads?
Well, you know what they say.
Oh, is that your wedding?
Oh yes, I still remember our wedding vows. We promised to tell each other everything.
Everything? Why did she have to look that way in our house?
Alice, I'm shocked. What kind of marriage is it where you keep secrets?
A long one.
Lady wife from whom I keep nothing.
Thank you, dear. And now it's time to play
the game.
What kind of game?
Full disclosure.
You take a sip from the sacred family chalice
and confess a secret you've never told anyone. And you have to absolutely tell the truth. And now, Gomez will break the ice. My husband has something he needs to disclose.
No, the host goes that.
Lurch, the sacred chalice.
This is the sacred Adams family chalice. Drink from it and your greatest secrets will be revealed.
I am in love!
You
also asked a lot of embarrassing questions and wrecked the whole thing.
That's different. My mother was condescending, judgmental, withholding, and loved nothing more than stirring up trouble. I've turned into my mother!
And what says you? Isn't it wonderful?
Adams, you've changed our lives.
Young lady, speak, step forward and speak the words every mother longs to hear.
I'm sorry. Mother, can we have your blessing?
Of course. May you have many children and may they give you as much grief as you've given us.
Okay, fun seekers, my acrimonial witness.
So I sniffed around a little bit.
Then what happened, you little bedbug?
You're also smart. You'll figure it out.
All right, let's see. You were afraid you'd lose your sister.
So you stole my acrimony.
To make Wednesday and Lucas fall out of love with each other.
But I never got to drink it because
I passed it to my mother.
And I drank it and became who I really am.
Which made me fall in love with my family all over again.
And I reached deep into my soul and forgave your father.
Huxley, you're an artist! You rearranged life itself and it all came out even. You're the best brother in the world!
So you're still gonna torture me?
Of course, until you get a girl of your own.
My son, you embrace the darkness of your despair and suddenly the world makes sense. You are a true Adams.
Love triumphs at last.
Aww.
My beloved ancestors, you are free to return. Till we meet again.
Yay! We aren't losing a doctor. We're getting 3 manicures. Welcome to the family.
Are you unhappy, my darling?
Oh, yes. Completely.
Stage. Thank you so much and have a great rest of your summer. Thank you.